This time on Hangover Airbrush, I put the Awada HPCS through all its paces and tell you what I think of this gravity-fed sprayer. Atomization. Although it has great atomization at higher pressure levels, it's a little bit finicky at lower pressures, primarily with the thicker paints. Now, you're going to have to play around with the pressure to get those fine line details that we love so much. One pressure does not fit all. Now, the operation and construction, I love the construction. I want to boast that this is a hardened stainless needle, a PTFE seal, and an 035 nozzle for fine lines and high paint flow. Now, one of the key features is the giant diameter threads that hold the head cap to the body, keeping the nozzle sealed. Now, these threads feel precise, and they are less likely to strip or break off. Now, it happens. Now, gravity fed means that the paint cup's non-removable, and a 1/3 ounce is kind of big, and I almost never use the lid because the cup never has that much paint in it. Still, as the saying goes, I'd rather have it and not need it than, well, you get the point. Now, the handle's cut away so that you can clear clogs a little bit more easily, but if it wasn't there, it wouldn't be a deal breaker. The needle doesn't have one of those stupid corona balls on the end of it either, so this lets you remove the needle from the front of the body, keeping the paint away from the inner workings of your airbrush. How cool is that? Now, the whole thing's covered in this easy-to-clean chrome finish, except for the inside of the paint cup. This is somewhat more chrome-less exposed brass, which is not so easy to clean. Now, the trigger pull was a little bit heavy for my taste, but not screwing the spring guide in all the way resolved that. Now, the kit I got came with 3 colors, cleaner, super lube, instructions, a pistol grip, water trap, and a pretty cool sticker. Now, the asking price was a little bit high, and I've noticed that Hobby Lobby's increased their price by $10. And at 209 smackaroos, I'd suggest you wait until you get one of their big discount coupons. Alternatively, Amazon has them without the water trap and the paint that I've never used for around half as much. And for that price, I say, why not? This is a great daily driver. It's got a nice feel. It's heavy enough, repeatable, and it's easy to figure out. While it can do fine lines, it's not really suited for that task as much as just general spraying. Unless you're doing metal flake or pearls all the time, I definitely find a place on my rack for one of these affordable Japanese gems. And that's my take.